Welcome back, everybody. We're gonna play more Wonderboy in Monster World. Before we head out into our next area, which I believe is the desert, there is a new shop open. Oh, wow. Excalibur. Yes. And a new shield. There we go. That's double the power of the Night Sword that we had. I really like the look of the steel shield. And the desert is immediately connected to the castle. And the thing here is, too, you immediately start taking damage when you're out here, unless you equip the Oasis Boots. So you gotta make sure you do that. And the snake sports me out. Great. Our new enemies are the scorpions. They can get kind of annoying if you don't immediately run up and hit them, because they shoot those little fireballs. Thank you, Arrow, for pointing the only direction we can go in. It's kind of a short area, but there's enough hidden stuff, like a little sand pit. You can just go right ahead and fall in. It tends to be like the little out-of-the-way areas like this that tend to be some of the most fun. And it's the introduction of our conveyor belts too, which will be a big part of the next dungeon. I really don't like the scorpions. I like doing those little hidden areas. Or you just jump a couple times and get free stuff. Go. Why did I duck? Around here is where the platforming can get a little dicey. But we get a new spell. Quake is actually a lot of fun too. It's, I think it's the same power as lightning, but of course, it only affects things that are on the ground. What's up through here? Now, for every bat that you kill, it actually conjures a platform, which can make this kind of annoying. So I believe you do have to kill every single one to get all the platforms. And they all move at a different pace. So jumping back and forth can be really annoying. Like that. And we just fall all the way back down to the bottom. Come on, there we go. And I just jump right back out. And back in. Pretty straightforward area. Outside of that sand pit and this well, there's really nothing to deviate. There we go. Oh, more shield magic. Just handy, but I think the only time I really end up using it is the final boss. Not magic. Need the marine boots. And the trident. We can go swimming. Then goes back to the cheery little let's explore music. And watch out for them spikes. Oh, that was weird. And we get the sun key. Still not a fan of the anemones. There we go. Alright, put her good stuff back on. I'm gonna make absolutely sure you put the Oasis boost back on. Oh, I didn't go down here. There's been many times where I've forgotten to put the Oasis boots on. And gone back up through there and just started taking damage and forgetting why. It looks like we're in a little pyramid of sorts. With a little mummy. There's nothing in that little room, it's just there to tease you. And here's the pyramid we were just getting a sneak peek of. The door is not open yet. This one is. Go inside. And it has really fat ghosts. The ghosts are a little tricky though, because if you miss the hit, they will fly away from you and then come charging in. They don't do all that much damage on contact though, so it's not too bad. And there's a chest to tease us. Now, there's a long series of ropes here. You could equip the ladder boots to make it faster, but you might overshoot it and the arrows could hit you. Our moon key, which we will immediately fall back down and open. I believe it is this door here. Yep, the moon door. Until you get the keys, they're just solid walls. And the pygmy shield. Which, as with the rest of it, cannot equip. I think all that we're missing now is the pygmy boots. So we have the sword, we have the shield, and we have the armor. Back up past the arrows. It's kind of a bit of a convoluted level design of this. Climb all the way up here, just go all the way back down. Flies away if you miss. And a new elixir. I believe if you already have an elixir, that one is just a full heart. So many ghosts. I'm dealing with the spikes and the mummies down here. Waiting for him to shoot his spikes. I just really don't like those conveyors. And they don't seem to affect the enemies at all. All the way back down. It'd be nice to be able to get through that gap. Can't like running slide or anything. I'm gonna tease us with that door there, but pretty simple. Firestorm, Quake, Thunder, Power, Shield. I believe it's one of every magic, except for Return. And it's our first bit of power, which makes you do double damage for a short period. I kind of think this is one of those old school classic traps that I don't think are used enough anymore. They can get rather annoying, but when they're done right, they're done right. So you gotta be careful with your timing. I don't know how to get the big ones, but just like the big knights, they just poke them in the feet and they go right down. And we're already up to our boss. So let's get ready for this. The Sphinx! So you've arrived. As you may have guessed, I'm the Sphinx. He talks incredibly slowly. I've got this thing for quizzes. But then you've probably heard that by now. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna ask you some questions. 5, to be exact. When you've answered them all correctly, I'm going to send you to a new world. Are you ready?
Well, I guess we're ready if we've been paying attention.
It's the first type of magic you acquired.
Well, that was Firestorm.
There we go.
Oh, I didn't look at the Charm Stone. I believe it's 5 million. Oh, no. That was bad. Yep, Felicity.
Traverse the Mohan Desert.
Oh, the Oasis Boots.
After defeating Grag and Glag, what did you receive?
The Trident. I love the Trident.
Only missed one. I'll let you pass. Jump from the top of the pyramid. Here we go with the last key. The star key. And here's our exit.
Now,
if you don't get all the questions right, or if you do get all the questions right, he gives you a bit of thunder magic, but the magic itself, really, you don't use all that much.
Here we go.
Now, climbing back up the pyramid all over again. So many ropes. Now this part you could put the ladder boots on because you don't have to worry about any traps or enemies. You just gotta remember to change back to a higher boot so you can run faster in this area. But to a new world, let's go. Oh, this is nice. Here's the thing. If you go back down here, get some of these. You can hear that rumble in the background. There's actually a boulder rolling down the hill at all times. Oh, and the music's familiar. Desert. Right here's the desert. If you hug the wall, right here, more power. There's actually 2. More shield. And then you fall back down to the bottom. Yeah, just take you right back into the desert. Snakes like to get back to their funny business from the beginning, where they don't drop anything. Scorpion between each door. And the scorpions get in on the game too, giving you nothing. Okay. This time, we're gonna fire up those frickin' ropes. And then you're slow on the sidestep. Higher boots back on. And while we're at it, put a potion on here, just in case. Yeah, for stuff like that. Put these little pigmen. Just like the boulders that the Dragon Glag spat out during their boss fight. Really hard to jump over without some kind of platform.
It takes a while to climb this mountain. But you may have noticed, since it connected right back to the desert, the Sphinx kind of lied to us. He didn't send us to a new world after all, just up this primitive mountain. Full of spear-throwing enemies. There we go. And a new castle. Sounds rather nice. Well, closed. Oh, is that a dragon? We'll find out what's available in this dragon town next time. See you guys then.